Many food crops need or benefit from pollination. Better pollination can mean more and higher quality fruits or nuts, and viable seeds for many vegetable crops. Without pollination, many crops would not produce the fruits and nuts that we eat. But what can you do to improve pollination when it's likely you'll have some cold or rainy weather during crop bloom? In this video, we'll be introducing the concept of integrated crop pollination and talking about different strategies you can use to maximize crop pollination and ensure quality, marketable yields. Integrated crop pollination is the combined use of different pollinator species and pollination strategies, such as habitat enhancements like wildflower strips and hedgerows, and other farm management practices to provide reliable and economical pollination of crops. What does this mean? There are two main parts to integrated crop pollination. The first part is to think about diversifying sources of pollination. Managed honeybees, alternative managed bees like blue orchard bees or bumblebees, and many different species of wild bees can all contribute to the pollination of fruit, nut, and vegetable crops. Diversifying pollination strategies beyond just one of these types of pollinators can help improve total pollination for many crops and manage the risk of poor pollination due to variability in weather, managed colony strength, and the many other factors at play during crop bloom. Different species of bees can complement each other's pollination of crop flowers by causing other bees to move more among rows, by visiting flowers at different times of day or at different times during bloom, by pollinating flowers in different parts of the plant or handling flowers in different ways, and by flying under different weather conditions. Some large-bodied bees, like bumblebees or carpenter bees, for example, will fly at lower temperatures and in rainier conditions than medium to small-sized bees, including honeybees. The second part of integrated crop pollination is implementing farm management strategies that support these diverse pollinator communities. The three main things that bees need are food, or access to nectar, pollen, and water, shelter, or access to preferred nesting resources, which might be hollow twigs or bare soil depending on the bee, and a safe environment protected from pesticide exposure. We can ensure access to these things on farms by planting habitat enhancements like wildflower strips, meadows, or hedgerows that provide bees with food and safe shelter, by using horticultural practices that support pollinators, like choosing flowering cover crops that provide resources for bees, as well as by taking steps to minimize pesticide risk to pollinators. These steps include using integrated pest management strategies to decide if and when sprays are needed. Consider alternatives such as mechanical or biological control options for managing target pests. Avoid pesticide sprays during crop bloom when bees are active in the field. If sprays are needed, spray after dusk or before dawn when bees are less active. Minimize spray drift outside of the field. Always read and follow the instructions on the label. Select active ingredients and formulations with the least toxicity to bees. And maintain good communication with your beekeeper. Notify them of spray plans in advance if there's a chance their bees will be exposed. Reducing exposure to pesticides helps bees stay active and healthy, allowing them to do their job pollinating crop flowers. By diversifying your sources of pollination and implementing farm management practices that provide bees with food, shelter, and a safe environment, you can expect more reliable, economical crop pollination from year to year. To learn more about integrated crop pollination and to determine which practical steps to maximize pollination might be a good fit for your farm, visit our website at www.projecticp.org.